There is one further and highly interesting body of evidence on the prevalence of the Kundalini experience, although given a different name, in the writing of another author who has developed his own interpretations of it. In seeking to research consciousness from both a philosophical and scientific perspective, I came across the title Cosmic Consciousness, a study in the evolution of the human mind by Dr. Richard Maurice Bucke. It is a particularly interesting text because it recounts the author's own experience of Kundalini, except that he describes it under the name of illumination or cosmic consciousness. Bucke describes his own experience. It was early spring at the age of 36, and he had spent an evening with friends discussing Wordsworth, Shelley, Keats, Browning, and Whitman. They parted ways at midnight, and he had a long drive home. His mind was full of the ideas, images, and emotions derived from the reading and conversation of the evening, and he was in a state of calm, almost passive enjoyment. Suddenly, and without warning, he found himself wrapped around, as it were, by a flame-coloured cloud. For a moment he thought of fire, and the next he knew that the light was within himself. Immediately afterwards, he felt a sense of exaltation and immense joyousness, accompanied by an intellectual illumination quite impossible to describe. Into his brainstem, Bucke continues, streamed one momentary lightning flash of Brahmic splendor, which has ever since lightened his life and thereafter always remembered as a taste of heaven. He saw and knew that the cosmos was not dead matter, but a living presence, and that the soul of man is immortal. He states that he saw and knew that the universe is so built and ordered for the good of all, and that its founding principle is what we call love. Bucke claims to have learnt more in that brief period, and that the illumination had made more of an impression upon him than all his previous years of study. The illumination only lasted a few seconds in time, but its effect was indelible, to the extent that it was impossible for him ever to forget what he saw and knew from that moment, and that he could never doubt the truth of what was presented to his mind. Bucke later describes the instantaneousness of the illumination as one of the most striking features. It can be compared with nothing so well as with a dazzling flash of lightning in a dark night, bringing the landscape which had been hidden into clearer view. This account seems very close to other experiences described in Caduceus. I consider it to be one of the most succinct accounts of Kundalini, or illumination, or entrance into cosmic consciousness, as Bucke describes it, that I have ever read, and further supports my contention of the worldwide prevalence of Kundalini. Up to this point, my case has been based on the experience of Kundalini by providing examples of it both in the context of spiritual texts of some antiquity and the writings of great thinkers. I then provided a foundation to my argument by paralleling these descriptions with those provided by the Kundalini commentators such as Gopi Krishna and Dr. Bonnie Greenwell. The aforementioned are relatively contemporary publications on the subject of Kundalini. Krishna was first published in 1970 and Greenwell in 1990. Yet Bucke's Cosmic Consciousness was first published just over 100 years ago in 1901. Bucke also writes of the bewildering and confusing nature of the experience. Individuals who enter into this experience of cosmic consciousness are, at first, more or less excited by apprehension, and then they ask themselves if what they see and feel represents reality or whether they are suffering from a delusion. He suggests that they doubt whether the new sense may not be a symptom or form of insanity, and suggests that Muhammad was greatly alarmed, as well as Paul. The fact that the new experience seems even more real than the old teachings of self-consciousness does not seem to reassure them. He goes on to say that each person who has had the experience eventually believes in its teachings, accepting them as absolutely as any other doctrine. Like others, Bucke also suggested that the experience was particularly difficult to describe. In support of my own arguments on light, Bucke reconciled himself with the illuminating experience years afterwards in finding examples of this subjective light in others. Indeed, the bulk of the content of his book, Cosmic Consciousness, consists of naming and providing descriptions of other illuminated individuals and instances of cosmic consciousness. His lists include Buddha, Jesus, Paul, Muhammad, and Dante, who, as I have described previously, experienced Kundalini. Obviously, Bucke predated Nietzsche and Jung, but had he been aware of them, I would like to think that they would have been included. Interestingly, Bucke names individuals including Francis Bacon, William Blake, and Balzac in his list, and others such as Moses, Isaiah, Wordsworth, and Tennyson within the category of lesser or doubtful instances. Bucke's aim in his book Cosmic Consciousness was to point out that there have lived in this world certain individuals who, not out of an extraordinary development or any or all of the ordinary mental faculties, but in whom the possession of a new consciousness peculiar to themselves and non-existent, or at least undeclared, in ordinary people see, know, and feel spiritual facts and experience physical phenomena, which, being veiled from, are still of most vital importance to the world at large. Bucke makes an interesting point, and one with which I agree and have based this book on. Of the individuals that he has listed, and the ones that I have described here with some overlap, Bucke suggests that if one or two of these individuals are studied, to the exclusion of others, the result would be inadequate and unsatisfactory compared to the study of all of them. If all are read and their testimonies compared, new light is thrown upon their accounts, and these supplement and strengthen those of others. I have stated earlier that this should also be applied to ancient spiritual texts.